Hey everyone, it's Caitlin and welcome to another video. In this video, I'm going to be sharing some summer inspired meal prep recipes with you guys. These are all recipes that I have personally been enjoying and loving this summer. They all have some fresh and tasty ingredients. They're full of flavor. So even if you do have to be in work and you're meal prepping for work or you're in school and you can't be by the pool at every waking moment of the day, you can eat these foods and you'll still feel like summer. If that sounds good to you, let's get on to cooking. For breakfast, we're going to be making berry yogurt parfaits, and this isn't necessarily a recipe, but I have been eating it almost every day this summer and it's so good and I want you guys to try it. You can use any vegan yogurt you'd like. Most grocery stores have them nowadays. I like this one by Lava because it doesn't have any added sugar. It's actually based from plantains, coconut, and peely nuts, so it's a really interesting combination of things, but I think it's really tasty. And I'm using the strawberry flavor for this video, but I like all of their flavors, and I also like how the yogurt's really thick. If I don't use this, I usually use an unsweetened variety of coconut yogurt or cashew yogurt. But basically, you're just gonna add your yogurt to a bowl or a jar. And I like to add protein powder to mine too and mix it with water, but that is totally optional, so I decided not to include it in this video. And then you're just gonna add some fresh fruit. Because berries are in season, I'm using strawberries and blueberries. And then we all need a little crunch, so I'm going to top it off with some of my homemade peanut butter cup granola. I actually just posted a video recently with this recipe in it, so you can check that out if you want. But we don't want the granola to get soggy, so we're just gonna store it in a separate container until we're ready to serve it the next day. And that's it, guys. This is really easy. But you should try it. There are also recipes online if you want to make your own vegan yogurt and do the extra step, but I just like to buy it from the store because it's a lot more convenient for me. Then for lunch, we're going to be making some white bean pizza burgers. And we can't eat pizza and we can't be at a cookout, but we can have all the flavor of a pizza in a burger. So to start out, we're going to be using some white beans. I'm using cannellini beans, but you can use pretty much any white bean that you want. Plus some cooked rice. The original recipe calls for red rice, but again, you can use whatever rice you want. I'm using brown rice in this case. And we're going to add both of those to a food processor, along with a thickened flax egg, which is 1 tablespoon of ground flaxseed with 3 tablespoons of water. And now for our pizza flavors, we're going to be using some tomato paste, some fresh basil, 2 cloves of fresh garlic, some nutritional yeast for that cheesy goodness, oregano, some red chili flakes, and last but not least, a little bit of salt. Then you're just going to put the lid on your food processor and blend this up until it is a thick and even paste. So in the recipe, you're actually not supposed to blend all of the beans and rice together. So we're actually going to transfer the leftover beans into a bowl and just mash them with a fork to give a little bit more texture to the burgers. And then we're going to add in the remainder of the cooked rice as well. Then we are just going to add that mixture that we blended up in our food processor and stir everything together. And this mixture is kind of wet, but it totally works out in the end. So you're going to line or grease a baking tray. I'm using a reusable silicone mat, and you're going to form 6 even burger patties and place them on your tray. It does help to have your hands a little wet during the step so the burgers don't stick. And in the meantime, I also decided to cut up some sweet potatoes and roast them in the oven while my burgers were cooking to serve on the side with my burgers for my meal prep. So about halfway through the cooking time, you're going to take the burgers out of the oven and just flip them over and then pop them back in the oven for the remainder of the time. And at about that time, the sweet potatoes will finish cooking too. As you can see, they look kind of dry on top, but the bottom side, you can really see how moist and juicy they are. Oh, look at that. It's like pure heaven. But those are our sweet potatoes for our lunches. And then our burgers should be coming out looking a little bit something like this. Even though the mixture was super wet when we put it onto the baking tray, as you can see, the burgers are nice and dry and crispy on the outsides, but they're still soft and slightly chewy on the insides. So depending how you prep for the week, you can store all of your burgers in a large glass container and just keep them in the fridge until you're ready to serve them. Or you can go ahead and pre-package them individually if you have enough containers to do that. So I'm using these pretzel buns. I bought them at Whole Foods, but I actually also have a recipe for pretzel buns on my blog. I'll link it below. You can also use a regular burger bun if you want, and then use some greens. You can use lettuce. I had some leftover salad greens, so I just used those. Top it off with our pizza burger, and then the best part, guys, is putting pizza sauce or marinara sauce on top of it instead of ketchup. It takes it to a whole nother level and it's so tasty. I also decided to add some red onion for a bit of crunch and tang, and then you just top it off with the burger top and put your sweet potato coins in. And if you want to serve your sweet potato coins with ketchup or hummus, you could totally put that on the side as well. Either way, it's super tasty. And fun hack, the red onion actually separates the marinara sauce from the top of the burger bun, so prevents it from getting soggy in the fridge before you eat it for your lunch. Last but not least, we're going to be making some banh mi bowls for dinner. So it has all the flavors of a banh mi, but it's in a bowl instead because we already prepped a sandwich for lunch and I thought we should do something different for dinner. So first, we're going to start out by making our crispy tofu. I took a block of extra firm tofu and I pressed it. I actually have a whole separate video on my channel about other tofu hacks and tofu recipes that don't suck. So I'll link it here in the video if you want to check it out. You're going to add this to a medium-sized bowl and we're going to sprinkle some nutritional yeast on top. Stir that around so all the pieces are evenly coated in the nutritional yeast, and then we're going to drizzle a tablespoon of tamari and a tablespoon of rice vinegar over the tofu cubes, and then stir that together again until everything is evenly incorporated. Then we're going to transfer this again to a greased or lined baking tray, and you want to spread the tofu cubes out so none of them are touching. Then we're going to pop this into the oven for 15 minutes, and while the first 15 minutes is going by, we're going to make the pickled vegetables for our banh mi. So first we're going to prep our pickled veggies. You want these to be sliced pretty thin, so we're going to be using some carrots, half of a white onion, some jalapenos to give it a little bit of spice, and some daikon radish. You're going to press these down into a glass bowl, and you really just want as little air as possible between the veggies. Now we're going to be making our pickling brine by adding 2 cups of distilled white vinegar, a tablespoon of salt, and around a tablespoon to a tablespoon and a half of agave nectar. I didn't have sugar, so I used agave instead, and it worked out perfectly, and I think agave is supposed to be like slightly healthier than sugar. I don't know, but either way, you're going to whisk this over the stove until it comes to a boil. And then once the mixture is boiling, we're going to pour it over our vegetables to pickle them. And as you can see, things got a little steamy here. But once all the liquid is in, you're going to press the veggies down. You want them to be completely submerged in the liquid. And we're just going to let this sit and come to room temperature. And at about this time, about 15 minutes or so should have passed, which means it is time to take our tofu out of the oven, give it a little flip, and then put it back in the oven for the remainder of the 15 minutes. And then in this 15 minutes, we're going to be productive again and make a creamy cilantro dressing. We're going to be using a base of soaked cashews and the flesh of a large jalapeno. I removed the seeds, so this dressing is actually not spicy at all because all the heat is in the seeds. But if you want to keep a few seeds in to make this spicy, you can totally do that. We're also going to be using a fourth a bunch of cilantro. You can use both the stems and the leaves, as well as a little bit of rice vinegar, some lime juice, some water to thin things out a bit, and some salt. Just pop that into your blender and blend it until it is smooth and creamy. I was so happy with how this came out. I used this dressing for pretty much everything. I put it on my banh mi bowls, I dip potatoes in it, use it as salad dressing for other salads. So if you make anything from this video, please make this dressing. But anyways, our tofu is now done. As you can see here, we have some nice and crispy cubes that are perfect for our banh mi bowls. So we are almost done assembling the bowls. The only step left is to combine everything together and to cook our rice noodles. I'm using brown rice pad thai noodles, and these are great because they only cook in 5 minutes. I will say rice noodles can stick together. So if you're doing this for meal prep and you have time in the evenings to cook your noodles every single night, you totally can do that. I would recommend that. But if you want to cook them ahead of time, we're actually going to drizzle on our creamy cilantro sauce now and mix this in with the noodles. And this helps them to stay more moist and not form into one large glutinous rice clump. And then from this point on, if you're prepping your bowls ahead of time, you're just going to add in the rest of your ingredients. So I used a small handful of mixed greens, some fresh pink radish, some fresh cucumber, add some of that crispy tofu in, and then we're going to add in our pickled veggies, our carrots, daikon radish, onion, and jalapenos. Top it off with a sprinkle of cilantro, seal it up, and you're good to go for dinner. Alternatively, if you want to cook your rice noodles as you make them, you can just plop everything into a bowl, make it as Instagram worthy or not as you want, and then just drizzle the creamy cilantro dressing on top and mix it in and eat accordingly. I personally prefer to eat these banh mi bowls cold, so I think it is perfect recipe for summer evenings as well when it's already hot outside. And that's it. I hope you guys love these recipes as much as I do. And even if you're not into meal prepping, you can totally obviously still make these recipes. I think the white bean pizza burgers would be perfect for a cookout or a fun evening dinner with friends. And the banh mi bowls would be great for that as well. And they're also just really, really freaking tasty and oh, they're so good. I wish I still had leftovers, but they were gone like 2 days after I made them. If you're still watching this video, tell me your favorite thing about your summer so far in the comments below. And if you're new here and like what you see, you can feel free to hit that little subscribe button right down there. I post 2 new videos every single week. And if you like this one, you'll probably like those because they're all pretty similar. And yeah, thank you all so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video. Oh, also, I hope you're having a fantastic day, whatever time of day it is for you. I will see you guys later. Bye.